Interstitial lung disease, or ILD, refers to a large group of respiratory diseases that cause inflammation and/or scarring in the lung tissue, or interstitium. One of the subgroups of interstitial lung disease is the one related to environmental exposures, referred to as hypersensitivity pneumonitis. Hypersensitivity pneumonitis results from the lung's reaction to an inhaled organic particle or antigen. This reaction can be inflammatory, fibrotic, or some combination of both. Some of the most common exposures associated with hypersensitivity pneumonitis include pet birds or feather products, mold in your home or history of water damage, hot tub or humidifier use, and agricultural settings. Hypersensitivity pneumonitis causes injury to the small airways and alveoli, or air sacs, in the lungs. This type of lung injury can be acute, in which case the problem is usually more inflammatory and reversible with avoidance of the offending antigen. It can also have a more subtle onset, known as subacute or chronic form, which can have a less dramatic presentation. In these cases, there is more fibrotic or scarring injury to the lungs, which is not fully reversible. Hypersensitivity pneumonitis presents with nonspecific respiratory symptoms, such as shortness of breath or cough. This leads to the identification of ILD, and further evaluation then leads to the diagnosis of hypersensitivity pneumonitis. A thorough history of environmental exposures, such as home and workplace exposures, is critical in the diagnosis of hypersensitivity pneumonitis. Unfortunately, even with a complete history, not all patients can identify the antigen trigger for their disease. Other evaluations include HRCT, pulmonary function testing, and blood work. Sometimes a lung biopsy is needed. One of the most important elements of management involves avoidance of or removal of the causative antigen exposure. In those cases where the causative exposure cannot be identified, the disease is more likely to worsen and the prognosis more serious. Similarly, if the antigen is identified but the exposure continues, that leads to a poor prognosis. Unfortunately, like some other types of interstitial lung disease, hypersensitivity pneumonitis can be progressive over time, even with the appropriate antigen identification and avoidance. Sometimes medications that suppress the immune system are used to try and halt the damage being done to the lungs and reverse the inflammation if it is present. For those patients who have progressive fibrosis as part of their disease state, their pulmonologist might consider the use of an antifibrotic medication. Additional research is ongoing to determine the best approach to this type of interstitial lung disease. Other important elements of treatment include pulmonary rehabilitation, supplemental oxygen if needed, management of pulmonary symptoms, and sometimes lung transplantation. For more information and support, please visit pulmonaryfibrosis.org.